The question of divorce is a difficult one. We know that in Malachi, God says that he hates divorce, but we see that divorce has penetrated the Old Testament, the New Testament, and even today. Our world is broken, and though this is not God's intention, his first intention for marriage was between a monogamous relationship between a man and a woman, and we see that in the book of Genesis. But unfortunately, sin is in this world, and our world is broken, and so we need to address the issue of divorce. But as Christians who may be divorced, does this mean that you're going to have to be single for the rest of your life, or that you've committed the unpardonable sin? Well, some people have kind of leaned into that ideology simply because they want to reverse the divorce rate within the Christian church. However, as a blog reader had asked on Monday of this week, Mei Ling, thank you so much for addressing this question. I want to go ahead and give the biblical reasons for divorce, and then also on the blog be posting up some reasons that I've kind of done some biblical research on and pass those along to you. But God tells us that he definitely does take marriage seriously, and Mark 10:9 says that what God has brought together, let no man separate, but our world is imperfect, and we need to address this issue of divorce because it's not only happening outside of the church, but it's happening inside the church. So the two biblical reasons for divorce are, number one, adultery, and we see that in Matthew 19:9, and number two, abandonment, which is 1 Corinthians 7:15. So if you are a believer and your spouse leaves you or vice versa, that is biblically acceptable. But what happens on the gray issues? Like, how do we go ahead and address those? I have posted some answers up on the blog, but if you yourself are divorced or are remarried to someone who was divorced, how is God using that relationship? For me, it's a personal issue because my current fiance is divorced from a biblical standpoint, biblical reasonings for his divorce. But what I love is that divorce did not break him, nor did it make him bitter against God, but it has actually made him a better person. And I'm excited to see and live out what God has joined together, let no man separate. So join in the conversation. I hope that brings some clarity. Mei Ling, thank you so much for your question, and I hope this helps. Have a great weekend, guys. See you later.